Hey everyone, it's Rob with Passport to the Parks, and today is Thursday, March the 28th, and I'm here at Epcot. I figured we do a bit of a walk around today to check out what's going on here. It's been a little while since I've been over here. We'll check out Ratatouille, which is actually right behind me. We'll check out Guardians of the Galaxy, the space restaurant. We'll kind of take a look up front, see what's kind of going on up there, and maybe a few other things. We'll hit the Skyliner on the way out as well over at the International Gateway. So we'll just have some fun. I actually went over to check out the Skyliner today, and the only line that I saw running was Hollywood Studios. They're actually running the line, different from what was last night where they were actually just doing the sitting stationary load test. They're back to running the line back and forth, which is kind of cool. Nothing between Art and Pop, and nothing happening between Caribbean Beach and Epcot yet. But it will. We'll get there. They're really moving along on that. So I will kind of change it up a little bit today, and we'll do the walk around Epcot. We'll actually come into the park. I met Dana, who watches on here, last night, and he asked me, he's like, do you really go into the parks ever? And I said, well, I love doing all the stuff on the Skyliner and all that stuff on the outside of the parks. So it's kind of rare that I get in here. So this is for Dana today. I came inside the park, do the walk around. Epcot, it's a gorgeous day, so why not, right? I got a bunch of people coming on here. So, hey, Greg, welcome. Bob, always good to have you here. Way Too Sun, hello. Kurt, welcome. Sorry to hear about the bus yesterday. Yeah, that was a... It was quite the ordeal yesterday. Robert Film Vlogs, good to have you here. Jackie, good morning, or good afternoon, actually, now. Menu Rager, hello, how are you? Danielle, let's see, just catching up on the live stream from last night. Everything is good from last night, guys. Chad, welcome. Jose, Liam, welcome, good to have you here. Modeling Disney, always good to have you here. Sunny Central Oregon, at least you guys got some sun up there. That's a good thing. Jamie from Oklahoma. Robert Film Vlogs, hello, hello, hello. All right, let me turn you around. We're going to take a look at a few things here. Let's see, Robert. Yeah, it does look warmer today. Last night was really cold. I mean, it was in the mid-50s, but the wind was blowing around, and it was, like, uncomfortably cold last night over at Hollywood Studios. So, much better day today. You can see the skies have finally come back to this gorgeous, gorgeous Florida blue skies. Let me turn you around here real quick. Let's see, who's this? Dan Kench, I believe. Hey, looks great. Coming in August from the UK, Catherine, Emily, and Olivia. You guys are gonna have an awesome time. I can't wait for you guys to get here. Robert, welcome. Chad, Greg, absolutely another beautiful day. So right behind the trees here, right kind of behind Morocco, in between France and Morocco, is the Ratatouille building. And you can really see a lot of it outside in the International Gateway. A lot of the construction, you can actually see a lot of it off of Epcot Center Drive as well. But this actually blends in pretty well with the surroundings out here, that you can barely tell that the building is here, which is very, very good. The trees really cover it up, which is a very good thing. We'll kind of walk around, we'll look at the other side, especially when we leave today. We'll see the outside of it, how it looks. There's going to be a lot on the other side of the France Pavilion here, as far as the entrance and everything. That's going to look really cool. The other thing that's on this side that I kind of wanted to show was how this Guardians of the Galaxy building is coming along and sort of blending in. Now, you guys know that I have not been a big fan of this at all. The construction has really been sort of a monstrosity, but you know, I'll give it a 50-50 chance here, because now that I'm here and I'm standing here again, they've actually painted it the sky blue. It actually does blend in better than I thought it was. So, you know, as much as I'm not a fan of this, obviously they still have the red chute there. They'll probably do something with, you know, that the launch chute. But as far as the building itself, it actually does blend in a little better than I thought it was going to, because, you know, when they were building it, it was just a complete eyesore, and it really took away from the beauty of the World Showcase Lagoon and, you know, Spaceship Earth across the water. So Disney is doing a pretty good thing as far as trying to blend it in and just making it look a lot better. So much appreciated for that. Still not a fan of it, though. We're going to wait for the Friendship boat to come around, and we'll jump on that, and we'll take that across to Future World. So we'll just kind of take a look at the beautiful view here while we're doing that. Zibbity Doodad, welcome. Scott, hey everyone, greetings from Indiana. Joe, hey, welcome, welcome, welcome. You finally caught me live, awesome. See, Grace, good afternoon, glad I caught you live. Woohoo, 2 days in a row, awesome. Menu Rager, I'm new. I just subscribed. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you so much. Chad, it's gorgeous here today. It really is. It's a perfect day. Sheila Wallace Photography, welcome. Brett, hey, love the updates. Hope to meet you someday. That would be very, very cool. I'd love to meet everybody that I talk to on here. Robert, we're going to hit International Gateway on the way out. So we'll kind of make a whole loop around. We'll see as much as we can. We'll hit International Gateway on the way out so we can check that out. So I'm going to run down here and jump on the Friendship boat. I'm going to try not to get into anybody's pictures here. Because there's not really much else to much else to see on the World Showcase side here. A lot of stuff happening over in Future World, though. See, Scott, sounds like you had a rough week, with people, security. Hopefully you had a smooth day. You know, security is never an issue. I love security here. That was just sort of a misinformation about the no filming. Last night, there's the incident on the bus. There was an intoxicated person that came on and was really, really not being pleasant with me. So, you know, that's a whole nother situation in itself. We've moved on from that. You know, you just try to have a good time here, and sometimes you run into individuals who don't want you to have a good time. So I do want to the reach out from support from everybody. I got a lot of emails last night. I'm going to try to answer them all, but a lot of support from emails and stuff saying that, you know, you really support the channel and really support how I handle things. And, you know, I always try to be courteous to people and take into consideration, you know, other people's needs and be nice. And I really appreciate the outreach from everybody last night. Just trying to be supportive with that whole thing. So much appreciated. Janet, hey, looks lovely there. Hope to see you in October. Coming from England. Absolutely. Like I said, it's usually best to email me like a day or two before you're here so I can kind of check schedules and stuff. So it's robatpassporttotheparks.com. Hey, David, welcome. Liam, standby access will not be initially offered to Star Wars Galaxy's Edge. Disneyland restricting time within the land. Yeah, we kind of knew that. They definitely weren't offering fast passes for anything, for a Smuggler's Run or anything. We're all going to be pretty much on the same level. We're going to walk in there. We're all going to have to stand in line. But, you know, it's going to be worth it. Just I'm more interested in walking around, seeing the land itself, and just seeing how incredible it's going to be. Zippity Doodad, welcome everyone. If you haven't subscribed, please hit that bell and like button. Rob is awesome. Thank you so much. Hashtag professional. I love it. Scott, love watching your updates with my three-year-old daughter. That is awesome. Thank you so much for that. Bob, thank you as always. Much appreciated. Thank you very, very much. Brett, Rob, how close will they let you get to the River Country project? That's on the list to do as well. I need a little bit more time. When I have a little more time, I'm going to jump on the boat from Magic Kingdom over to Fort Wilderness. So we should be able to see some of that, and we'll walk back by that Mickey's Backyard Barbecue. You can kind of get back through there. You're not going to be able to get too far back in there, I would assume. Now they probably got a lot of it fenced off. And of course, we never go beyond any point that we're not allowed. But I definitely want to go check that out. A lot of it's probably leveled down there, so we'll see what we can see. But it's definitely one of the projects I want to check out. Hello, how are you? Sheila, love the Skyliner updates. Thanks for providing them. We'll be there in May for yourself. Very, very cool. Can't wait for you to get here for that. You're going to love it. All right. All the seats outside were filled up, so we'll just get a window view inside. SW Brick 75 was there last week, and unfortunately we did not see the Skyliner running at all. Oh well, hope it's in use when we go again in mid-August. You might be very, very lucky in mid-August. I'm pretty confident that they are going to have at least a portion of it open by mid-August, if not the entire system. They are just moving along so quickly. Everything is just way beyond the schedule right now, so I'm really impressed with what they're doing, and I cannot wait to see an announcement that they're going to open this a lot sooner than we think. Nick, hey from Indiana, welcome. Going to be here in October, very cool. Liam, Walt Disney World Parks banned smoking beginning May 1st. You know, I saw something about that this morning. So they're going to ban smoking inside the parks beginning May 1st. That's interesting. I think they'll have some people upset about that, and some people will be happy about that. So we'll have to see what the opinions are going forward. John, hoping to having a good day. 79 days till you're down here. Very cool. Way too sun. Very cool. Always fun to meet a fellow Hoosier. Nice. Greg, what's my opinion about the Club Cool going away? You know, I did hear that, but I also heard that it's going to be sort of relocated. They're not going to get rid of it totally. I think that's way too popular for them to just totally get rid of. So I think it'll land up in another spot. But I did hear, you know, as part of that whole renovation project up there, that's all going to be redone and moved. Maybe you guys have heard more than I have about it, but you can, you know, put it in the comments if you guys know any details about that stuff. See, Kurt, yesterday you were saying at D23, exciting news coming. All I'm saying about that is don't be surprised. You know, I'm not guaranteeing anything, but don't be surprised if you see some major announcements with the Disney Skyliner and not just the common, you know, maybe shooting over to, you know, phase two to the Disney Springs or the Animal Kingdom. You know, let's really, really keep an eye on what's going to happen at the Magic Kingdom. That is a very, very, very busy park. And there's some really massive transportation options out there as far as gondola systems go. So just keep an eye on that. D23 could be pretty exciting. Even if it's not D23, just in the near future, there might be some pretty exciting news coming. Robin, we go to Coronado in August, and I'm so excited for these changes. Part of me wants to keep it all a big surprise, and the other part of me is glad to find out everything in the last detail. Well, you know, obviously it's always better to see it in person. Seeing something through a screen is nothing compared to what you're going to see when you're actually standing in front of it. So you're going to be surprised no matter what. Even if you know some details going in, it's going to be gorgeous. It's going to knock you off your socks, I promise. Hey, Matthew, welcome. That's all right, guys. Casey got the chicken pox. I'm sorry about that. I hope she's feeling better. Everything was fine from last night, guys. It really is. But thank you for the outreach. And, you know, just crazy stuff happens sometimes. We just got to be safe and keep everybody safe. Jamie, you have a feeling they're going to open the gondolas on July 29th. There you go. Let's lay some money down on it. You might be right.
We got a good spot, someplace between UK and Norway is a good location. Also over there in front of Italy.
See, John, as a smoker myself, the new ban on smoking makes no difference to me. If I want to smoke, I'll gladly go outside the park and just come back in when I'm done. There you go. There's from an actual smoker. So, like I said, opinions are going to vary. You know, everybody has opinions. Disney is doing what they think is best for, you know, the general population. And, you know, we kind of have to go with what Disney rules on. They're trying to make the best environment for everybody here. Jeffrey, hey from Utah. Danielle, unfortunately, I'm not going to D23, not this year, but Greg, who is on here, is actually going to D23, and he's going to keep us up on all the cool stuff that's coming out of D23. David, the weather is gorgeous here in October. I love it. It's still warmer. The nights are a little cooler, but not really cold. I used to travel down from Ohio all the time in September and October. Matt, welcome from Hornby Island. Joe, going to pop in September. Looking forward to riding the Skyliner. Very cool. We are all looking forward to riding it, my friend. Matt, I'm going to get over to Coronado very soon. If not, it'll probably be sometime next week. I definitely will get over there, though.
Alrighty, folks, welcome to Canada. Make sure you have all of your belongings and watch your step.
Alright, let's head off the boat here. Disney, any idea how far it is around World Showcase walking distance? I believe, you know, I'm not 100% sure, but hello. I want to say it's a mile. I think it's a mile walk all the way around. That might be all of it, the entire Epcot walk, but you know, I just didn't want to walk the World Showcase today because there's not a whole lot as far as construction is going, and it takes a little while to do it. But I actually love the walk. It's a gorgeous walk, but I want to say it's like a mile from what I've heard. Maybe somebody else on here has actually did the distance or did it in steps on their phone or something like that. Hey, the BOMO, welcome. Craig, welcome to Canada. Look at that, we went from France to Canada in less than 10 minutes. Way Too Sun, we've always done spring, this year going in November. The spring is definitely busy and you get a lot of rain in the spring and stuff. In November, I think you're gonna be really well. It really starts to dry up through the winter months. The weather is a lot nicer. You're still gonna get days like this in November where you get mid 70s, low 80s, and the nights get a little cooler, a little colder, but it's not really till like December and January to really drop down into the, you know, the low 40s as far as the nighttime.
Where's she went in a bush?
Now the Flower and Garden Festival is going on, so we'll see some really great topiaries along the way as well. That's a whole nother video in itself. Got Huey, Dewey, and Louie here, they look pretty awesome. Check out Mickey and Minnie here with the hearts. Very popular photo spot. It's good to see they got the photo pass photographers out here. But they look absolutely beautiful. Work our way around here.
I got you started at 2:45.
Got a little bit of a crowd as it condenses down a little bit here. We'll try to work our way over to the right so we can stay out of people's way.
Look, Donald and Daisy.
That's what I meant.
Oh, this is cool. They got Goofy up here too. Now, they used to have these guys up front, so I'm wondering what is up front now. I haven't been here yet. I guess Dana was right. I haven't been into the parks very much lately, just because I've been following so much on the outside with the Skyliner and all that. Greg, yeah, I love the topiaries. Disney is just magical when it comes to what they can do with these topiaries, just with the landscaping in general, the flowers, the way they keep everything beautiful. You know, all the green, the grass. We'll take a look real quick here. I really don't want to get too much into the Flower and Garden Festival today, but some things are just too beautiful to pass up. So we'll take a quick look over here. This is always just a gorgeous picture. It's really pretty. So I want to head over towards Test Track right now. Between Mission Space and Test Track is the new space restaurant. This truly is just a gorgeous day. You know, we get lucky sometimes when you don't have humidity and you just have a little bit of a breeze and the gorgeous blue skies and these beautiful clouds. I need to get, there was someone on here last night, I apologize, I can't remember the name, but he just graduated from college in for poetry. So I need somebody like him who can actually put into words some of the things that I want to say sometimes, because, and I'm very limited as far as how I can describe some things, but I try. It's like in that movie Contact, where she goes and she's traveling through space and she starts to cry and she said, oh, they should have sent a poet. That's sometimes how you feel when you're walking through Disney World. It's like, they should have sent a poet in here. Greg, when the Skyliner opens, I should be the first to ride it. I totally agree. Got Buzz and Woody. Bo Peep is going to have a pretty significant role in Toy Story 4, it looks like. Kind of some things floating around there that she might be a villain in the movie. Which, that would be pretty interesting if that actually happens. Just a whole little play area over here, kind of dedicated to Toy Story. All right, let's go find this. Let's go find the restaurant. I'm trying to remember what's the easiest way to get over here. I think we'll go this way. CJ, welcome from Orlando. You know exactly how beautiful it is here today, then. Zippity Doodad throwing the park rules up there. Hopefully I'm not breaking any of those rules. Pasta Fazul, is Guardians of the Galaxy a ride, a family type roller coaster, or more of an extreme thrill ride? It's definitely gonna be an extreme thrill ride. It's supposed to be the largest indoor roller coaster, I believe, in the world. Maybe the country, but I believe it's the world. So it's gonna be a pretty massive, thrilling roller coaster. There's a launch. So probably something similar to the Rock and Roller Coaster. Now it's kind of funny, as much as I don't like roller coasters and I don't like adrenaline and stuff like that, I actually like Test Track. I've ridden Test Track a couple times and you know, it's fast, it's pretty intense, but it's more something that I can definitely handle. It's pretty loud, too. All right, so here is our new space-themed restaurant that's gonna be built. This is really coming along. Looks like they have the exterior walls. Last time I was here, there was just the iron framework. So this is very cool to see. So you can see basically what's going to happen is, this is, sorry, it's loud here. This is all rounded in the front, so this is all going to be screen in the front. It's going to give you that illusion that you actually go up into space to like the International Space Station, and it's going to be this massive panoramic view of the space. You know, you're going to have astronauts floating around. You know, I can assume that they're probably going to have like asteroid hits, and you know, kind of I'm picturing something like the Rainforest Cafe or T-Rex or something like that, to where it'll be very immersive, very interactive. And you know, while you're in there, you know, something could, you know, asteroids can hit, and who knows? I mean, the endless possibilities. You know, astronauts will come up and maybe tap on the window like you're in there, you know, like you're inside the space station or something. I think it's just going to be a lot of fun once we're in there. But it's literally going to have this illusion, I guess, to where you're getting into some sort of a space elevator or ship or something, and it's supposed to take you up into space. So it really gives you that realistic feel. Sharon, don't stone me, but I'm really excited for Guardians. That's awesome. I mean, I want people to be excited. Obviously, you know, people got to love it. It's just my own personal opinion. There's a lot of stuff that I love that's going on, but the Guardians is just not for me. I want to get a couple pictures while I'm here. Hang on one second. You know, it's not so much that it's just a roller coaster, because I don't like roller coasters. It's not that. It's just the theming of it, I don't believe, fits into, you know, what Epcot, I mean, we won't even get into what Epcot originally was and Walt's original vision, but the original concept for Epcot as a theme park was supposed to be about innovation and looking into the future, which I could see, you know, this is probably a very, you know, advanced technology that they're using. You know, it's going to be about space and things like that, but it's just, it's characters being pushed into here that I don't think it fits into the purpose of the future world aspect of Epcot. You know, if they wanted to put thrill rides in, my opinion was they should have put mountains, you know, put a Mount Fuji back there, a roller coaster back in the World Showcase. You could do like a bobsled theme back in Germany, you know, something like that. They could have put roller coasters in here and really had amazing theming that would have went with, you know, with World Showcase. But as far as Guardians of the Galaxy, you know, let alone that it's this building that's actually blending in a little better. I'm not too disgusted with the building anymore. But just the fact that it does not fit with the whole innovation thing that's going on here. And maybe they're just trying to reinvent the park itself, which is kind of a bummer. You know, I remember coming back in the 90s. The 90s was the heyday, especially for Epcot. It used to be my favorite park, which kind of recently transitioned to the Magic Kingdom. But back when, you know, this Mission Space used to be Horizons. Horizons was here. Test Track was the World of Motion. You had Journey into Imagination was actually with the Dreamfinder, which was amazing. You had like Food Rocks over in the land. You had Body Wars, which was in the Wonders of Life Pavilion over here. Now, a lot of people weren't a fan of Body Wars because it was very, it's kind of a nauseating experience and very, very jerky. But it was just another great experience. It was all about learning. It was all about advancement. It was all about technology. It was all about, you know, taking dreams and building them into something, and they're just sort of losing touch with that. Now I'm kind of curious, I'm really going to give this a shot, this new play pavilion that they have going on here at the old Wonders of Life building. So this should be very interactive. You know, from some of the concepts, there's a lot of characters being brought into here as well. So if they want to centralize this and kind of make this more of a character spot, interactive characters, more like a Ralph Meets the Internet kind of thing, you know, that might be kind of cool too, as long as it has some sort of an advancement towards, you know, learning and, you know, changing the world, those kind of things. You know, Walt Disney's vision was, you know, use this as a concept to develop new things that they can share with the world and make the world a better place. So now, does Guardians of the Galaxy make the world a better place. I love watching the movies. My daughter is in love with Groot. And, you know, I'm a huge Marvel fanatic. But being here is just out of place. You know, they could have done this in a different park. Make that fifth gate. Come on. Make your fifth gate. All right, I've lost a lot of comments here. I do apologize, guys. I get rambling on about this. And see, Donnie, have you seen the bus guy today? No, haven't run into him again. Hopefully I will never, ever have to encounter that person again. Just a very unpleasant person. Melissa Gray, welcome, welcome, welcome. Modeling Disney, smash that like button. Boost the video. Thank you so much. I know you guys have been talking about a bunch of different stuff here. See, Randall, that wall was soundproof. The wall, so you don't hear anything of a test track. Oh, you're talking about the space restaurant. I never even thought about that. So that's good that they soundproofed it. Yeah, could you imagine being inside the space restaurant and hearing the test track going whipping around there each time? So good point. I would have never thought of that. All kinds of pictures. So it's good that you can't actually see, just these trees right here actually obscure the vision of the building. So really the only way you see the building is from the parking lot and, you know, back in World Showcase, which it does blend in. I will give Disney props for that. I'm really curious to see what they're going to do with the front entrance here. You know, it's just going to be a giant billboard for Guardians of the Galaxy, I'm sure. Danielle, I think we'll be planning a 2022 trip, our first trip in late October this year, and I'm already planning trip number two. That is awesome. So you're going to be here pre the 50th and post the 50th. I think it's awesome. You know, to be able to experience a lot of the stuff being built and then to actually see it when this whole project, the whole 50th anniversary project, which is all the parks, you know, Magic Kingdom, Epcot, Hollywood Studios, the Skyliner, all these hotels and everything that they're doing, is just going to be unbelievable. I remember, you know, when they started announcing this stuff like 5 years ago, it was like, there's no way. I mean, they can't do all this stuff. And now you see it piece by piece, it's starting to come together. You know, the groundbreaking for Tron, you know, this monstrosity here that is almost done. The Ratatouille ride back there is really coming along. The Skyliner itself, I mean, how amazing is that? Galaxy's Edge opening early. You know, what we think is impossible sometimes, Disney does make possible. I think we all got turned off a little bit with Pandora because that took so long, but it's so immersive in there, and they really push the envelope on Galaxy's Edge, which I think is going to be even more immersive than Pandora by far. So I'm really happy to see that they stepped the game up and they're really investing a lot into getting all this stuff done. So hopefully D23 will give us some new announcements for what they're going to do in the future. You know, my fingers are crossed for a Pixar land over at Hollywood Studios. The fifth gate. I mean, everybody, the fifth gate would be amazing. Go Browns! Somebody had a brown shirt on. They're my new best friend. Way too soon. Walt did say it's fun to do the impossible. Amen. He did say that. So here's Club Cool. So apparently this whole area is going to change. It's going to be renovated. A lot of the stuff is going to be taken down or moved or reconfigured. You know, I'm not the buff on what's absolutely everything technical that's happening here. You know, I'm just hearing the things that you guys hear as far as Club Cool, the Fountain View, all this stuff. All the innovation stuff is supposed to be redone or taken down and reconfigured into different things. So it'll be rather impressive. Spaceship Earth is going to have a whole overhaul on the inside. You know, there's actually a time where I thought that turning Spaceship Earth into the Death Star would be a good plan. But that idea has passed. I'm really thankful because I would have just totally gone against everything that I've just been saying about what Epcot is actually about. I guess I'm just kind of a Star Wars nut, so seeing a giant Death Star was just cool. I don't know if you guys remember, they actually they did the laser lighting on the outside where they made the Death Star. And it looks pretty cool. Tab and Kurt, I will miss Ellen's energy. Always amazed me how many people could get into that ride. And it wasn't that bad. Let's see, amount to do the people riding a big fan of slow rides. I am too. That's why, you know, back in the heyday, you know, Horizons, World of Motion, the Dreamfinder. That's kind of why I love this park so much, is because it had a lot of those dark rides, a lot of educational things, you know, how, you know, from the wheel, World of Motion was the wheel, all the new transportation into the future. Horizons, I think, was just the best ride that Disney has ever done. That was just an amazing experience. Did it become dated? Of course it did. But, you know, they could have found ways to update it. I mean, I totally understand why it's gone. There was foundation issues. They lost the sponsorship. Blah, 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 blah. But
hi, baby.
Sometimes I wonder why people don't divert at all to the left or right. Like I try to move as much over, like I shrug my shoulders over and move my body over as far as possible, and some people just do not move at all. It's kind of, you know, I hate to use the word rude, but, you know, we have to share the walkway sometimes through here. So of course, all this is going to change. This is what we definitely know. You know, this is all going to be expanded out here. The pillars are going to be removed. They're actually going to be relocated over, from what I hear, that they're going to be relocated just to the left of the monorail station by the bathroom area, kind of in the front, outside of the gates. So I'm glad to see that they're not actually going. The pillars themselves, I don't believe, are going out there. They're just going to take the panels and they'll put, put them on a smaller structure or a wall or something out there. But the panels will definitely still be here. They're just going to be outside. But this is all going to change. This is all going to be redone with floral and fountains. It'll look really nice. So you can see the Guardians building still in the background. So this is more of the construction. You can see a lot of the launch, the roof. This is the queue up here. This is the old Ellen's Energy building. And then you can see the actual roller coaster itself back in the distance here. So you will be able to see a lot of it from the front, but it's not an overwhelming eyesore, I don't think. Ernesto, a lot of people feel they're entitled, yeah, using father's account. Yeah, unfortunately, that might be the case. Jose, sorry, Rob, missed the bus yesterday. What happened? Tried to see the replay. The actual video I put into private mode just to, not to respect the person that was on the bus giving me the hard time, the intoxicated person, but there was another person on the bus who I wanted to show some respect for, so I took the video down. I thought about blurring anything and, you know, just to make sure. But just out of respect to that person, I'm probably going to keep that video down. He was actually being very nice and trying to, de-escalate the situation a little bit. But the intoxicated individual you know, just wanted to keep calling me names and you know, making threatening statements and stuff. And it was just, it was very uncalled for. It was just, it was intimidating. He went from one side of the bus and came over to my side of the bus and sat right next to me. And, you know, it was just this awkward situation where, you know, he just wanted to make me feel intimidated. And it was not a good situation. I put the camera down to the floor, actually. If whoever watched it, I had the camera down to the floor the whole time and just pretty much stopped talking just because, you know, I thought the guy was gonna, you know, eventually do something that he probably shouldn't have. Joe, good manners have become a thing of the past. Well, I push good manners here. That's why I always try to give people the benefit of the doubt and try to treat people like I'd want to be treated. Wait, your son Rob was amazingly professional and dealt very nicely with the mouthy drunk. Yeah. Thank you for that. Tammy, I'm looking forward to the 50th as well. Yes or not, be surprised. Let's see, if it ran for 2 years. Disney is doing some amazing work in preparation for the update, putting on new rides. Can't wait. Absolutely. Kevin and Teresa, experimental prototype community of tomorrow, not Marvel World. Yes, get that contract situated with Universal already and make your fifth park, make a Marvel park or a villains and a heroes park or just a park about aliens, or I don't care what you make a park about. You own 21st Century Fox now. You have, you know, maybe that's the thing. This 21st Century Fox deal is going to be a massive load of content that Disney can now bring in. So it doesn't necessarily even have to be Disney based. You know, there's so many properties that they could invest into a park now. It could really be some amazing stuff that they can come up with a fifth gate. I mean, I love the new lands. I love Galaxy's Edge. I love New Fantasyland. I love Toy Story Land. I really hope that they expand into a full Pixar land over at Hollywood Studios. But, you know, I think the public is speaking, and we want that fifth gate. We love the new lands, but it's not enough. We need more space. We want to stretch our legs. We want to, you know, stop rubbing elbows with every person being crammed into the parks. But Disney knows that. They're going to do what they can do as soon as they can do it. Danielle, right, it's tea time here in the UK, so I best go feed my family. My hubby wants an Aliens ride now that they have Fox. Absolutely, bring back the alien encounter with actual aliens. Bring back a version of the great movie ride. You have so many different properties that Disney now owns. You know, they don't need a sponsorship for it. They can so many amazing properties they can movie ride together. Or something similar to that, a whole adventure, these wonderful properties that they have. The sky is absolutely the limit. If you can dream it, you can do it. And that was Horizons too. Oh, I miss Horizons. Hey, Street Cred, welcome. Happy Thursday. JW Dasso, my favorite place is coming up, Starbucks. There you go. From what we're all hearing, this is all going to go too. Starbucks, Club Cool. Again, I hate to say that it's going to go, but I think it's going to be repurposed, relocated. You know, they're definitely not going to want to pull Starbucks out of here because it's so popular. And Club Cool, you know, they got to do something else with Club Pool. Plus, I mean, you know, Disney's pretty much married to Coca-Cola all over the parks. It's all Coca-Cola, so. You know, I wonder if they would take Club Cool and put something over in the actual Coca-Cola store at Disney Springs. Wonder if that's an option. It'll certainly be different walking through here. Sometimes change is good. To change is always meant to evolve into something better. But I just, I want to stick to the guidelines of what that change should actually be. Try to grab some comments here. We'll give you a pretty shot and see. Kevin and Teresa, just imagine what Walt Disney World, or I'm sorry, what Walt Disney would think if he could be watching Rob reporting live from Epcot. I'm sure he's smiling down. Oh, that man, that makes me feel really good to hear that. That's I'm a huge Walt Disney fan, so his whole perspective on things, his morals, and his dreams and visions and stuff. I mean, I hold the same ideas and values and things like that. So, I would really hope that he would, you know, smile down on a lot of things that they're doing here. Some things I think he would say, I don't think I would go for that. I think he would be really, really impressed with the Skyliner, actually. That's definitely bringing, you know, new and fun transportation. It's almost a vision of what he had for Epcot, you know, in the beginning when he had the people mover, the monorails, you know, all these transportation systems that would take people to and from all over property. Originally it was supposed to be to and from work and, the entertainment complex back to the, you know, to their housing developments and things like that. But I think the Skyliner, Walt would be definitely happy with what's going on there. Bobby World, Epcot, less future world concrete and more trees. I'm fine with that. I mean, I'd love to make it more beautiful in here. Bob, the August 29th date for Star Wars is not a full opening. The Rise of the Resistance attraction is not open till the end of the year. Absolutely, that is correct. The Smuggler's Run is going to be the only thing open. No fast passes available. Everybody's just going to kind of walk in and wait the whatever it's going to take to get in. The Rise of the Resistance is going to open later in the year, and that's the one that is really going to knock people's socks off. I mean, just hearing how intense and amazing. I mean, there's going to be scenes in there where you have actual, you know, full-on cargo bays with stormtroopers, like actual stormtroopers in there, you know, animatronics, and, you know, hundreds of them, I guess, and these huge AT-ATs are going to be, you know, bigger than the Guardians of the Galaxy building, and it's going to have these massive battles. And I mean, that is going to be so immersive and so awesome. Smuggler's Run is going to be fun. You know, it's going to be kind of the simulator thing. You go through and you get to do all kinds of interactive stuff, and it's the Millennium Falcon, which is awesome. But Rise of the Resistance, that's going to be where it's at. So take all the time you need, Disney, to get that right. Melissa, I hope they relocate Club Cool as well. I really do think that they will. Jose, good call on taking off the video. Yeah, I figure that's for the best. You know, I'm not here to stir up controversy. I just move on from those kind of things. People will be dumb and, you know, just move on with life. Disney Dreamers or Disney Dreams Net. Good afternoon, Rob. Looks like another beautiful day in paradise. Absolutely. Thank you for being here. Street Cred, if Jose Andres has a new restaurant in Disney Springs, I'm not too sad about another Starbucks going. Pirate Harry, wife says Club Cool is just moving. That's what I've heard too, so I really think that it's just going to move. JW Dasso, I'll be at Disneyland May 31st. Oh, you are lucky. You got to share stuff, man. If anybody, you know, you're going to D23, you're going to Disneyland, you're going to be there for Galaxy's Edge and Disneyland, definitely share some stuff, you know. Bring stuff on, even if you send me pictures or something like that, or you send me a video. You know, I'll share it out to everybody, and I'll give you credit for it and all that. It's just awesome to see, you know, and other people have to get experiences. I love that you guys can share my experiences here, so I would love to share your experiences as well. I'm just a, you know, big Disney sap as everybody else here. This is what I used to do. You know, back in Ohio, I would watch these kind of videos all the time. So the more we can share with each other, the more fun we're all gonna have. Ooh, a citrus poached salmon. That sounds really good. Gonna have to get a day with the family to come here. And we all have some time together, and we'll come through and we'll sample a bunch of stuff. I actually have to get my wife on camera. She never likes being on camera. John, Robbie handled yourself well last night. With that guy, many thumbs up for you. Thank you very, very, very much. Anthony, I am on Facebook. If anybody wants to follow any of my social media, easiest thing to do is just go to passporttotheparks.com. As soon as you get on there, you'll see all my social media, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and YouTube. Really easy to do so. Plus in all the videos as well, all the YouTube videos, just look down in the description. I got links to all the social media down there as well. Go Tribe! Indians! Cleveland Indians hat.
Love that it connects. We were making.
All right, just a pleasant walk through Future World into World Showcase. We won't take the friendship boat this time. We'll actually make our way through Canada and the UK. I got so many people watching from the UK, so I'm sure they're going to appreciate going through the UK. Then we'll head out towards the International Gateway. We'll take a look at the Skyliner. Candace, happy to meet you last night. I'm not sure what happened with last night's live stream, that you were there, but Sun will update me. If you have it private, please let us know. Have a good day. I've been talking about it a little bit. There was just an incident on the bus heading over to Caribbean Beach from Hollywood Studios last night. There was a person who was, you know, had the reek of alcohol coming on, and he kept telling me to stop live streaming because he didn't like me talking. So I told him that I would talk a little more silent for him, and I lowered the camera to the ground just to try to appease him. So he decided that he was gonna come and sit right next to me and just make rude comments to me the whole time. I think he kept calling me a creeper and just stuff like that. Just really being out of line. His wife, I felt bad for his wife actually, because she was actually sitting further back in the bus and she kept telling him to stop. Like, she was embarrassed that he was doing it. So obviously probably behavior that he has exhibited in the past. Look at that. He's got a name tag on. Look at that. What's his name?
Winston.
What's up, Winston? Oh, my daughter would love you. That is awesome. All right, Winston. Do they sell Winston's? Oh, of course they sell Winston. Great, she's gonna see this. I'm gonna own a Winston probably by the end of the week. Anyways, the whole situation, you know, it's just intimidating. And, you know, I tried to tell him, you know, I'm trying to appease him and blah, 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 blah. So I just left the camera down and didn't really say much. And everybody's really supportive on here. And I didn't even get off at the stop I wanted to get off, because he got off at that same stop. And, you know, God forbid that I would have gotten off and he would have tried something. But, you know, it's just, it's kind of scary sometimes when you have to deal with those kind of situations, but we move on again. But thank you all the support. Like I said, people have been emailing me and stuff saying, you know, how supportive they've been and that I handled the situation really great, and it's much appreciated. But absolutely, just kind of want to move on from that, and that's not what Disney is about. That's not a representation of what Disney is. That was just, you know, his opinion and directed towards me for whatever reason. But Disney is an extremely safe place. I love coming here. Yeah, I always talk about how good security is, you know, and coming up and making sure that everybody's safe, even questioning me, you know, no problems ever with the questions that they ask me. It's about keeping people safe, and I'm totally for that. All right, we've come through the UK. Of course, we have Winnie the Pooh and Rabbit and Tigger. My daughter's favorite thing in the whole world. She still has her Tigger from when she was 1 year old. We bought Tigger at a Disney store in Ohio. And Tigger has seen some days, but she still stays, sleeps with Tigger, and is just the best thing in the whole world. I love Tigger. Sharon, thank you so much. For Winston, $5. Hey, we're starting a fund for Winston. A Winston fund to get Winston for my daughter. That's awesome. Thank you so much, Sharon. Much appreciated. I always love the super chats, guys. You know that. Very grateful, especially last night. The overwhelming super chats from last night was just out of this world. I cannot thank all of you guys enough for contributing to that. And I think it was just based on the situation. I know that you guys felt bad for, you know, kind of me sitting in that situation, but much appreciated from all the support last night. I do love this over here too. Captain Hook, Peter Pan. How cool is that? Anthony, I'm coming back in December for my kids' Christmas break. Very, very cool. Definitely email me before you come. Anthony, can you send me a friend request? Sorry, excuse me. Actually, best thing to do is go to the website, Passport to the Parks, go to my contact, and I think I have a link to my Facebook in there. So if you click on that link, send me a friend request. You can find pretty much everything you want to know on the website. So any way that you want to follow me, it's best just to go to the website and find out all that great info over there. So we got a really great picture spot here, obviously with the backdrop of France with the Eiffel Tower. But we can also see the top of the Ratatouille construction. We'll see a little more of this once we get out into the International Gateway. But let me zoom in a little bit.
Oh, wow. Look
at it. So that's the top. That's the top of the building for Ratatouille. And then just over to the side, they're doing more construction. This will be the walk area that, where's my fingers there? Oh, ooh, that's zoomed in. You'll walk back in that area. There's gonna be that new crepes restaurant. It's gonna be back there, as well as the entrance to Ratatouille. So I'm truly, truly looking forward to Ratatouille. Let me try to show you one more thing over here as well. So the good news is, as they put this fence up, I put a picture up of this fence a while back, but you can see the Skyliner Tower here. So the Skyliner comes right into the International Gateway, which is just beyond the gates over here. But this fencing area here, this is all going to be new security area that they're going to expand, ticketing and security, which is going to be a good thing because you're going to have the influx of people coming through here. So very positive that we're going to see some construction finally happening, some expansion back here, because right now there's basically just two gates to get through. I'm trying to find my best way around here. So we'll head on out. Robert, heading to International Gateway now, my friend.
Yeah, I'm going to go.
So it can get a little congested here sometimes. You know, don't think this is going to be massive crowd levels back here. Again, during the day, it's just going to be your normal amounts of people that are coming in. They're just using different modes of transportation to get here now. This is, again, mainly going to be used to get people out of the park. Illuminations at night. Right now, you know, most of the people go through Future World. So you're going to take and alleviate some of that pressure getting out of Future World to come through here and get on the Skyliner and get over to the Epcot resorts where you can walk or take the friendship boats. So anytime you can, you know, kind of scatter and dissipate crowds and, you know, fan them out a little bit, that's always a good thing. Especially if you've ever been here and you've been caught in those crowds, you know, it can be very tight. You get a lot of people, it's really crowded and congested. All right, I don't want to get security on camera, so I'm going to keep it over to the right a little bit here. Let's see, Richard, when does spring break end? That I'm not sure. Kind of spring break is different. My daughter had spring break last week. Some other people had spring break the week before that. Some people are on spring break this week. As far as Florida schools go, you know, different schools across the country, you know, all through March, the beginning of April would be considered spring break down here, which there really hasn't been a huge influx of crowds. It hasn't been too terrible. So this is nice to see. You have all the fencing is down around the friendship boats. This has been down for quite a while now, but it's just, you know, you finally get that beauty back of finally seeing the boat stop here. Here's the fence that we saw from inside. So this is all fenced off. It's right next to security, which is on my left. This is going to be the new entrance heading around into the Ratatouille ride. So this will all change. You can see everything's kind of boarded up over here. They're going to redo a lot of this. That new crepes restaurant is going to be back in here somewhere. You can see the amazing Skyliner towers. A lot of people, you know, talk about the go-away green color on these towers. These towers were actually put up with that color. They were installed that way. So as far as, painting the other towers, you know, if that's indeed in the cards, they won't do that till very, you know, past the testing phases, because they have to look for structural integrity in the towers. They'll do x-rays on the towers for any kind of cracks or foundation issues, those kind of things. And then if they do decide to paint the towers at any point, they could paint the towers through like Caribbean Beach. Who knows if they will or not, but, you know, obviously, you know, they want this thing to look beautiful. I mean, look how beautiful this station is going to be. It really fits into the whole elegant look and feel of the International Gateway. It's got these beautiful pillars. You know, it's kind of hard to see way back there, but there's beautiful pillars back there. There's these gorgeous sort of atrium, you know, entrance and exits on either side. Of course, the gorgeous, gorgeous mural on the front with the cranes, or the igloos, I think they're called. We see them all over Florida here. They're little lizard eaters, actually. I was crazy the first time I actually saw one. Didn't know what he was doing. He was poking around in the bushes, and he flings his head down in the bush and comes up with one of those little lizards. It was a horrible, horrible experience. I told my daughter about it, which was a mistake. So now she was all, she's all upset about that. But hey, you know, it's a circle of life. Disney said it. So let's swing back here. We'll take a look at Ratatouille. Beautiful friendship boat coming in. So again, this is another example of, this is where you have a line queue and you have a lot of people that will enter in here, and they stand in the queue and they wait for one boat to come, then they put a bunch of people on the boat and they take those people out, and you're still standing in the queue. The Skyliner is a whole different experience. You're still going to have a queue, but it's a constantly moving line of people. So they're constantly putting people on. There's constantly gondolas coming out and entering into the station. So it's a rapid moving process. This is a capacity monster that Disney is building. You know, the amount of people that they're going to take back and forth is going to be really, really amazing as far as industry standards go for, you know, mono cables themselves. It's beautiful. It's fun. It's fast. You know, 7 meters a second is about 15 and a half miles an hour, which is the max speed, which the D line is capable of. Disney is even pushing that for emergency evacuations. They're pushing beyond that 15 mile an hour speed if they have to evacuate. Again, you know, Disney, number one priority is safety. And, you know, they hear these things. They know, you know, people are worried about electrical storms. They're worried about, you know, air conditioning in the cabins. They know all that stuff, and they're making sure that they have as many precautions in place as possible to ensure that A, guests are safe, and then B, guests are happy. So they're gonna do a good job. We're gonna love these things when they're done. I promise you that. But just a beautiful station. This really, really fits in well here. And again, gorgeous views. We saw last night standing at Hollywood Studios, if you were with me last night, the fireworks views, especially there. You can see Epcot's fireworks, you can see Fantasmic, you can see the Star Wars fireworks, you can see the Magic Kingdom fireworks, all from up in those gondolas. I saw it standing right on the sidewalk there. So the gorgeous views you're gonna have, you know, especially coming in here over International Gateway, you know, imagine seeing illuminations coming in here right on the World Showcase. Disney knows what's up, I'll tell you that. See, Pirate Harry, where does the gondola station ride to? This particular line right here goes through the Boardwalk parking lot. It makes a turn down Buena Vista Drive into the Riviera Resort, which is still being built. Then it makes another right-hand turn into the Caribbean Resort, which the Caribbean is actually the central hub. From there, you can transfer over to Hollywood Studios. You could take a line over there, or you can transfer and go to the Art of Animation and Pop Century Resorts. Street cred, same here. My family has a family cooking restaurant startup channel, and we're new on YouTube thing for the past few months. I didn't know that. Send me a link to your channel, Street cred. I'd love to check that out. Whereas, did Bob say? Oh, yeah. Let's not get into that either. Last night there was an issue. Somebody was giving somebody else a hard time on here about some of the donations. And again, I do not support that at all. I'm so thankful for all the contributions that people make here. And I do not want any negative comments about anybody on this channel. So especially after what I went through on that bus last night, you know, to have, you know, any kind of bad comments about somebody else is just not going to be tolerated here. So Modeling Disney, so they're filming new versions of China, France, and Canada films. I did hear that as well. So it'll be great to have them updated. Jeremy, have they done any testing on this line yet? The only thing that they've really done is, you know, they will move the gondolas in and out of the station. There's one gondola still parked in there to where they test the inner tracks. They haven't done actual full gondola tests or load tests. They're moving a gondola back and forth between the Caribbean and the boardwalk turnstile, the 90 degree turn there. So I have some video and some pictures of that if you want to check that out. But as far as testing this line itself, this is going to be the last. Obviously, it's the last in line, but it will be pretty soon. This line is pretty much ready to go as far as testing. So I wouldn't doubt if we don't see this in the next couple weeks as well. But they're really moving along on pop and art, full load testings. Beginning over there, you know, more and more weight on the lines, more and more gondolas. Hollywood Studios is pretty much ready to go. They're going to start cast member testing, definitely beginning of April. There's actually some internal people, some Doppelmayr people that have ridden it, that have said that it is an amazingly beautiful and smooth ride. Disney has taken out all the stops as far as how amazingly perfect this ride is going to feel and be inside. So, you know, if you have any fears about heights or, you know, jerking around and stuff like that, it's a beautiful ride. It's a smooth ride. And this is coming from, you know, people who ride these things all over the world, who actually build them. So to hear something like that is really promising. See, DJ Rhea looking for you while we were down there for 2 weeks. Didn't see you about, oh, that's a bummer. I wish I would have run into you. But good day from Nova Scotia, Canada. Thank you for being here. Street cred, back to the forest area, to the Skyliner towards Hollywood. Is that going to stay? It could be gorgeous ride out of Hollywood from the hub floating through those trees. Yeah, there's a clearing there. That was actually all trees at one point, and they cleared all that out prior to them building back there. So that's probably going to stay fairly similar. I mean, they may try to spruce it up a little bit. It's kind of just like dirt and construction stuff back there now, but I'm sure they'll make it look a little nicer. They're really doing a lot of work down Buena Vista. I posted some pictures on Facebook that they're taking all the construction fencing down there. They're starting to do the landscaping around the turnstile at the boardwalk. So like I said, it's little details. They keep, detail by detail. Each day they're doing something to make an improvement, to get closer to really getting this open. See, Rob, it was not a bad comment. I simply said the donations were not a competition because Joe Nated donated $100 and said, and I quote, now that's a super chat, putting down others have donated less. Okay. Well, like I said, I just don't want controversy. I appreciate everybody being here. I appreciate everybody's comments. I guess it's in a point of view on how we look at things, which is respectable. I think moving forward, just let bygones be bygones, and let's all just be a nice, happy community together, and everything will be fine. I do appreciate the explanation, though, Bob. That's very true. Everyone does not have the same amount of money. That's why, like I said, if it's a penny, if it's $100, if it's $1,000, if it's nothing, if it's just a kind comment, everything is supportive here, and I appreciate every single person for being here. So I totally agree with you on that. Let's see here. 2000 Dan LB. Hopefully I said that right. Chris, the stations have mechanisms to change the tension on the cable as needed. Yes, they have. In each one of the stations, there's a hydraulic arm that puts tension on the haul rope itself, so they can adjust the tension as needed. That's a lot of what the testing is done as well. As they move the gondolas, they'll do sudden stops. They'll adjust the tension on that haul rope to make sure that everything is perfect and that haul rope stays perfectly in line in the sheaves. Anthony, you're doing a great job. Thank you very, very, very much. Street cred, let's drop the super chat. Sounds like a good idea. Let's all just all here to have a great time, and I appreciate every single one of you guys. I really do. Bob, thank you. We appreciate you. Thank you very much, Bob. Pirate, have you ever eaten at Cape May? We did excellent food there. It was a while back when we actually ate there, but fantastic seafood buffet. If you guys love seafood, that is absolutely a thumbs up there. Steve, $5 super chat. Thank you so much, my friend. Always, always appreciated. I will put that towards the Winston Bear for my daughter. Very, very cool. If we get Winston, I'll bring her here, and if we get Winston, we'll be sure to share that with you guys. CJ, Cape May has a great seafood for the value. Richard, another great stream. Thanks for bringing Walt Disney World to us. Absolutely. Just gonna have you give you a beautiful picture here while I catch up on some comments, and then we'll probably take off here in a bit. Sharon, I watched them do the wire splicing in a different county. It was fascinating. Yeah, isn't that an amazing process? There's only just a couple people in the world that are qualified to actually come in and do that. They fly these people in from, it's like Germany or Austria or some place, but you have to have very, very specific qualifications to do that, obviously, because you have thousands of lives that are counting on this line. but it's a very long process, and where they take and they intertwine these cables together, and they splice the cables together into the haul rope to make it one full haul rope. Just an amazing process. You can actually look it up on YouTube. Just look up like haul rope cable splicing, things like that, and you can find it out there. It's an incredible process to watch. Rob, I like the way you make lemonade out of drunk lemons. Yes. A little too much whiskey in the lemonade. Paul said in a much cooler, Cardiff Bay, wishing I was there. In a much cooler, hopefully I said that right. I wish you were here too, though. Absolutely. There's enough room on this bridge, trust me. Enough room on the bridge. We could all fit here. We can all just enjoy the Florida weather here. Got the Surrey bike over there, which is always fun. Jeremy, favorite resorts, beach club, boardwalk, or yacht club? I mean, you can't beat it. I mean, this is just gorgeous here. Just to stand here is an amazing view. Sorry, I'm just trying to shoot back through some comments here. Steve Winston, here we come, yes. Modeling Disney at Disney Springs line could be very popular. I don't think it's just about popularity. Again, you have to look at the Skyliner as being sort of a mass transportation, and you need it in parks for, say, Galaxy's Edge. So Disney Springs doesn't have the mass amounts of crowds at one time that come out of the park. So running the Skyliner over there just doesn't make a whole lot of sense for them. I don't want to say financially, I guess, but it just wouldn't make a lot of sense because you don't have those huge influx of people. So to build an infrastructure like that over there just because it would be cool, I don't think that'd be too far in the plans. It may be in the distant future, but I don't think in the near future. Again, look at the Magic Kingdom. We really need to keep in mind of what's going to happen there. Massive transportation systems out there. As far as gondola systems are concerned, you know, they have systems out there that hold 30 people on a gondola. You know, there's things that might be floating around out there about even larger systems than that. Massive amounts of people that come out of the Magic Kingdom at one time. So let's keep an eye on that. Michael, thanks for all you do, bringing Disney to us when we can't be there. Thank you, Rob. Thank you for that very nice comment. Thank you so much. CJ, love people watching at the boardwalk. Definitely, definitely. It's a perfect place to do it.
Yeah.
Modeling Disney, guaranteed a fifth gate opens with a Skyliner station ready to go. That could be there as well. Yeah, exactly. Who knows what the fifth gate will be? I mean, that could be a massive undertaking in itself. And, you know, having a massive system coming in and out of a fifth gate, that could be another situation. Great idea there. Yeah, I totally didn't even think about the fifth gate. Who knows what the possibilities are there? They're definitely going to have transportation coming in and out of there. SW Bricks, told last week that the Skyliner is not listed as transportation, but rather as an attraction, hence why there is no Skyliner transportation cards. Thoughts? I haven't seen exactly what they're listing it as. For some things that I have seen, I've seen listed with buses, with the actual boats, not the friendship boats, because the friendship boats are attractions, monorails. So I've seen them lumped in with that. So I don't know 100% for sure whether or not it's transportation or an attraction. It's outside of the park, so it's most likely going to be transportation, because that's kind of the way they categorize it. Buses, the boats that are transportation are outside of the parks themselves. So like the friendship boat is really considered an attraction inside because, you know, it's inside of Epcot. The monorail obviously is transportation, buses are transportation. So the Skyliner most likely I would assume would be transportation as well, because it's not actually located inside of the park. See, 2000, it is listed as transportation when you look at the resorts on the Disney website. So there you go. Laura, thank you, Rob. Thank you, Rob, from us that are not able to be there, it feels like we are at home. That's exactly what I'm going for. I'm glad to hear that. SW Bricks, guess I shouldn't listen to those dang bus drivers then. Nah, come on, the bus drivers, I love the buses. And the bus driver last night, thumbs up to my bus driver from last night on that incident. He actually stopped me on the way out and he said, he's like, hey, I watch all of your vlogs. And I forget the exact words that he used, but he said, you're very courteous and very informative and you did nothing wrong back there. And I said, wow, that's really awesome. So he was like watching the whole thing, probably in the mirror as well. So it was really nice to hear him tell me that on the way out. So I love the bus drivers. Sometimes, you know, people, you know, you get information, sometimes it's right, sometimes it's wrong. You know, it's, in the end, we'll try to get the best, most correct information. Everything that we say here, you know, sometimes it's 100% right, sometimes it's a little, you know, far to the right or left, but we always try to bring it center once we find out exactly what that information is correct. I don't even know if I said that right, but you know, that's the ultimate point, is to try to get it to where we know it's right. We try to get it as best as we can. You know, I have a lot of people who are very much in the know with these types of things, especially the Skyliner. People that, you know, have built these things, have operated these things, they know all about this stuff, so. Liam breaking, all new Magic Bands now come equipped with built-in smoke detectors. Oh, jeez. Please tell me you're not serious about that. Yeah, this smoking thing is going to be a very, very controversial thing, I think, for Disney. So is alcohol in the parks. And we see kind of what alcohol does from last night's incident. So who knows? Who knows, you know, people like to smoke for the stress relief, I guess, and, you know, who knows what that'll be, a lot more tension. It already can be very tense as it is. You're here with your family, it's all day, you got a lot of stuff going on, you got the kids. You know, if you people watch, there's a lot of tension sometimes between families, and sometimes that tension can burst, you know, just with the slightest little thing. So it's, we'll have to see how that works out in the end. Everybody likes the smoke detector thing. Jeremy, with the added resorts currently in construction and some new ones scheduled to start, I would assume there'd be a fifth gate created at some point in the future. You have to. I mean, you have to think that way because these parks are so crowded right now. They're just bringing so many more people in. I love it. I love the resorts. I love everything that they're doing, but we need space to go. I mean, you know, 2-3 hour wait times on a lot of rides, and you just need to fan people out. You need to give them more options, more opportunities to go to different places. Plus, you need to compete with what Universal is doing. They're building that whole, Nintendo Land with some other stuff over there too. That's going to be amazing. It's not a land, it's a park that they're building over there. So I really think Disney's going to come out and they're going to slam the fist down on the table and say, this is what we do and we do it the best. Massive stuff, fifth gates, new lands, you know, massive new transportation systems, D23. I think they're gonna kick us all in the pants, hopefully. Michael, what's the info about the smoking? I missed it. Apparently May 31st or something, that there's gonna be an entire ban on smoking inside the parks that was announced this morning. So not sure how they're gonna handle that. I guess you'll be able to smoke outside of the parks, but inside the parks themselves, there's going to be a ban on smoking. All right, everybody. So I think that's a pretty fun tour for today. I actually went inside the park. So I actually do go into the parks sometimes. As much as I love the Skyliner and I spend a lot of time there, I do love the parks. I love going inside and enjoying this. I really like when I have time with my family to actually come to the parks and have some fun. But A lot of cool stuff we got to see inside. Obviously, cool stuff happening here with Epcot, with Future World and the Space Restaurant, Guardians of the Galaxy. I'm not going to come down on the look of the Guardians of the Galaxy building anymore. I'm going to give it that 50-50 option that really does blend in with that blue sky. So I wasn't under-impressed with it. I wasn't too upset with it. Now on a gray or gloomy day, that thing's going to stand out like a sore thumb because it's that blue color. But I think Disney did a nice job as far as trying to blend that building in a little better than it was when it was being constructed. Ratatouille, the same deal. You can't really see it behind me now, but it really blends in with the trees and the green back there. So, Disney knows what they're doing. We all have our opinions. My opinion, we all know when Guardians is not the greatest, but I always give Disney the benefit of the doubt. You know, wait till the finished product is done and then make a determination based on that, because until it's completely done, until we physically see it, until we physically experience it, you know, we can only have opinions until then. So appreciate all you guys being here. Again, follow passporttotheparks.com. Again, find all the social medias there. Any way to contact me, you can always find there. Appreciate you going there. The super chats, again, thank you very, very much today. And let's all just have a wonderful time moving forward in the future. Whoa, geez, I almost dropped my camera. Sorry about that. I'll be back tomorrow, definitely. Hopefully we'll have another gorgeous day and maybe a little Skyliner action. Sooner or later, we're going to get this this Epcot line running for the... where's my... There. I'm a little centered there. We'll get this Epcot line running, and we'll go from there. Have a great day, guys. We'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.